Okay.
We'll be pulling all the way to the first boss. The only thing you have to pay attention over here are the heavy attackers. They can one-shot you with their heavy attack. And the summoners summoning adds really. As long as you can manage that, it's quite easy. There are, of course, the random hands, one attacking and one killing along. But they're fairly easy to avoid. Yeah, let's AoE it over here.
Okay.
Alright, the first boss. This is one of the easiest bosses in the game. The only thing he really got is a frontal heavy attack
This
that
creature
creates a
killed
fire
our
field
man.
in front of him.
Watch out for the axe.
The fire field doesn't even do that much damage, nor does the heavy attack, but it's good to avoid it.
Coming. Be
careful. Here we're pulling again to the boss. It's a pretty long stretch, so try to keep together and save your slides after you aggro the pack. There are several packs that will like summon themselves from under the ground along the way. You might need to like pop some defensive cooldowns on the last.
No worries.
Got the healing hand as well spawning. So if you need a heal, you can heal yourself. Alright, this is the second boss. It's the toughest boss in this dungeon. That doesn't mean it's actually really tough. You can do it two ways, without preventing him from burrowing or preventing him from doing that. Preventing it's a lot easier, but it makes him enraged. If you won't gonna prevent, he's gonna spawn a lot of small, very hard hitting.
Yep.
Yeah, he always. It's very hard to prevent it on the. He only got pretty much two attacks, one is jump and the other one is enrage, and he starts moving very slowly during the enrage. You can easily kite him as a range, as a melee it might be a bit painful and both like waiting.
Mm-hmm. That's the charge you want to avoid? And just destroy his bird.
They surrounded us and drove us towards the center of the island. I don't remember escaping.
Alright, if you go left over here, you can enter the optional boss. It's usually not worth doing unless you're farming gear. And this way we're going to the last boss, which is pretty much one of the easiest bosses in it. He literally self-destructs. He stands in the middle and there are several hands being summoned from around the boss. Let's go to the adds first over here.
They tried to force us right into its jaws. Please destroy it.
Anyway, back to explaining the boss. See those tunnels around the boss area? That's where the hands will randomly spawn. One will be healing, the other one will be damaging it. You have to grab the healing ones while destroying the other ones and move yourself in a proper way as you're gonna be on the opposite side of the damaging one.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty much self-explanatory once you watch how we fight. all the health. All the... Tried to grab that healing and it just didn't work.
That's it. Never mind.
Maybe because I was 4 hit points or something.
Possible. Sometimes the hitboxes on them are a little off as well. And that's that.
Yep, one dead boss.